Welcome to the M-Pesa Business to Customer B2C product. Float or funds deposit. Before an organization can start using the business to customer product, they will need to deposit funds into their shortcode. To make a deposit to your business to customer account, you shall be required to make either a cash, check, RTGS, or EFT transfer to the M-Pesa holding company bank account at either KCB or CBA. The beneficiary bank account details at KCB or CBA shall be a combination of a prefix 333 and the M-Pesa business number or shortcode. For example, if your organization's M-Pesa business number is 123456, the beneficiary account number details shall be 333123456. The account details are shown below. Funds will be credited into the organization's M-Pesa business to customer account within 45 minutes. That is except checks, which will take 3 working days to clear. In case of any inquiries regarding float deposit, kindly get in touch with us via email on m-pesafinance@safaricom.co.ke or call 0722-004980. Confirming funds or float deposit. An M-Pesa business to customer organization has two accounts, MMF or working account. The MMF or working account is where all the deposits to the M-Pesa system are credited into and where all the withdrawals from the M-Pesa system are done from. Utility account. This is the account where the business to customer transactions are carried out from. It shows the payouts made and the charges per transaction. In order to make payments, the funds received in the MMF or working account have to be transferred to the utility account. Moving funds from the MMF or working account to the utility account. The operator will then be able now to log in with their newly created password. So shortcode remains the same. Username, the operator's username. Password, the same password that the operator successfully created. And verification code is the code that appears on the screen. Click to log in. The operator will then receive a one-time password once again, which will be sent to their phone as a text message. So they'll type it in, then click submit. So the operator will have successfully been able to log in. So the operator will now be able to confirm the funds that were deposited. You can have two tabs. You have two tabs. You can click on account view. So account view will display the details of their working account and the details of the utility account. So the working account shows the balance that was deposited as available balance, and it shows the balance in the utility account. The second way of checking the balance, you can click on the Browse Organization tab. In the Browse Organization tab, you have a view which displays the B2C code and the organization name. And at the bottom here, you have the details of the working account, also the details and the balances in the utility account. So to move funds, the business operator has two options. The first option is on this tab showing initiate transaction, or this tab on my functions also having initiate transaction. So you can click either of them. So you can click initiate transaction. Clicking initiate transaction, you can be able to click the summary of accounts tab. It will once again display the details of the balances in the working account and the utility account. So to move funds, the business operator will select the transaction services drop-down option. This will display all the different transaction types that can be done from a business to customer account. So to move funds, you select business service, where you move funds from the MMF or working account to the utility account. Select that. Then you move on to the next mandatory field as displayed by these red asterisks. So you'll type in the amount. So the minimum amount that you can move from the working account or MMF account to the utility account is 5,000. Then you will be required to type in the reason. So the reason can be any reason as to why you're moving the funds. So you can type in a reason. Scroll down, then click submit. So the business operator will be able to initiate the transfer, which as displayed here does not incur any charge. There is no cost for moving funds from the working or MMF to the utility account. Once the business operator moves the funds, this will require an approval by the second user, which is the business manager. So the business manager will be required to log in. How business manager approves the payments. So the business manager will now log in with the details that were sent to his or her email to be able to approve the transfer from the working to the utility account. So enter the short code, which is the B2C number. The manager will enter their username. The manager will then enter their password. And the manager will also enter the verification code. This is the code that appears on the screen. Click to log in. The manager will also receive their one-time PIN, or rather their one-time password, which is sent as a text message to their mobile number. They'll type in the one-time PIN. Submit. On entering the one-time password, the manager will be required to log in to change the password. So we'll enter the old password. The new password is required to be put in with a minimum of 8 characters that combine letters and numbers. So we'll enter the new password. The manager will then confirm the new password. Then the user will select question that they'd like to use. Then they'll put in an answer that is easy for them to remember but difficult for anybody else to guess. Then click submit. Once the password has successfully been changed, the manager will return to the login page. The business manager is now ready to log in to approve the transaction of the funds movement from the working or MMF account to the utility account. So the manager will be able to log in with their password. They'll enter the short code. The manager will enter the username that they have. The manager will enter their own password that they were able to successfully create. The verification code will be the same code that appears on the screen. And the manager will log in. The manager will then receive a one-time password that is sent as a message to their mobile number. So they'll key in the one-time password and click submit. To approve the funds transfer from the working to the utility account has two options. You can click on the tab showing My Tasks, then click Group Tasks. Under Group Tasks, the manager will click Search. On clicking Search, this will display the pending transaction. It will show the initiator of the transaction, that was the business operator. It will also show the status as processing. To view or approve the transaction, the manager can click on the process icon or the operations icon. It will then display the details of the transaction. It will show that it is processing and it is pending. It will also show that it's a business transfer from the MMF or working account to the utility account. This transaction will also display the amount that is being transferred. The manager has an option to approve the transaction and put in the comments and submit. The second way to approve a pending transaction of funds transfer from the working to the utility account is by selecting this icon showing transaction. The manager can click confirm. On clicking confirm, it will display the transaction that is awaiting approval. It will show the time it was initiated, the transaction type, that is the transfer of funds from the MMF or working account to the utility. It will also show the amount that is awaiting to be approved. The business manager will then click on the transaction to select it. The manager will then type in a reason in order for them to be able to complete the transaction. So here we can write funds transfer approval. The manager will then click submit. Once submitted, the funds will move from the working account or MMF to the utility account, and the business operator will now be ready to make payments. Support and escalation. For float deposit inquiries, send an email to m-pesafinance@safaricom.co.ke or call 0722-004980. For any other inquiries, send an email to m-pesabusiness@safaricom.co.ke or call 0722-002222.